You've changed. You're thriving. There's something about the walls. Not just surviving. You're blossoming in the woods. And oh, my dear, please stay the same forever. And then out here, you're passionate, charming, considerate, clever.
What was that? Was that me? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me? And kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up! Stop dreaming! Stop prancing about the woods! It's not beseeming. What is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband, you can't live the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds. Why not both instead? There's the answer, you're clever. Have a child for warmth and a finger for bread and a prince for whatever. Never hits these woods. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always or is it never end? That's what woods are for. For those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, then you'd never know you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment who can live the woods. And to get what you wish only just for a moment, these are dangerous words. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Just remembering you've had an end when you're back to war makes the orb mean more than it did before. Now I understand.